Hi my beauties and welcome back to my channel. So today I am going to recreate for you all this easy gold black eye makeup look, and this has been created by me specially keeping in mind EID that is coming along around the corner. So I hope you all will enjoy my effort, and if you do, then please don't forget to give this video a massive thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you people haven't already. Don't forget to comment below what other videos you people want to see. And there's a giveaway going on my channel, so don't forget to participate in that if you people haven't already. And don't forget to follow me on all my social media. I have a Facebook and Instagram. And please do let me know in the comments below whether you people want me on Twitter as well. If it is so, then I would love to create an account on Twitter as well. So with that being said, let me not just waste any time further and share with you all how I got this makeup look. So starting off with foundation, for which I am using this Freedom Pro matte finish foundation, which is actually not a matte finish foundation. Don't go on the name when it comes up to this foundation. It's seriously very glossy, shimmery kind of a foundation, but I love it because it's one of my favorites. So I'm going ahead with it and then blending it with my Damn Beauty blender. I know it looks a little bit lighter at the moment, but it will get settled into the skin. Then taking the NYX Conceal Correct and Contour palette, I am taking the concealer shade from the same palette and I'm applying it under my eyes. It's the first time I am using this palette as a concealer as well. Usually I use the color correcting shade from the same palette, but this is seriously a full coverage concealer palette. Literally, it turned out, the makeup look turned out so awesome, and my dark circles, they are like least visible. If you people have observed, they are least visible, literally. Then using the darker shade from the same palette, I am using it for contouring my face, and it turned out so natural on the skin. It's looking so very easy, and the blending process was a little bit, you know, tough, because you people know this palette is tough to blend. Then I have spread some rose water onto my face, and then I'm starting to blend it off. Like literally, you have to break your hands while blending it, and I am taking my Damn Beauty blender for the sake of blending this. But once it is blended, you can see how full coverage, shabam type of a coverage it actually gives to you. It's amazing, this palette. I don't know why I haven't used it till date for the sake of concealing, color correcting and contouring for all the purposes. I don't know, guys, but I seriously am telling you that this palette is very good. This is really, really amazing. Now I have put it to a different type of a use, and I'm loving the use of it. And this took me a little bit more than the usual time that it takes me to blend. But now, taking my Chambord Sheer Delight compact powder, I am just pressing the compact powder into the areas where I have applied that concealer. Now this is a creamy concealer, and it was the first time that I was using it as a concealer. So I thought, let me just press a compact powder that I love, because it actually, you know, it will help me not to crease throughout the day. Now taking the LA Girl Go Glam palette, I am just going to bronze up my skin with the bronzer that is present in that palette. I'm not going to go skeptically with the contouring thing. And I'm just bronzing up the areas where I did apply that darker shade of concealer. It's just an amazing palette. You have all the things in one single place. You have a bronzer, two blushers and one highlighter in the same palette. And it's just an amazing idea according to me to go ahead with a palette. Now taking a combination of both the colors of blushers from the same palette, I'm just applying them onto the apples of my cheeks, just making sure that they are having that blushed, beautiful, pinky sort of a look, which actually unintentionally matched my dupatta of the lehenga that I'm wearing. And then I'm just highlighting with the help of the same highlighter. I don't know why people criticize this highlighter. I find it really very beautiful. It complements the skin tone so pretty well, and it's just an amazing highlighter to go ahead with. Now taking the Freedom Pro Dip Brow Pomade, I am just grooming up my brows with the help of it. Just make sure a small function even requires your brows to be groomed up. I can't emphasize more upon the fact that your brows should be groomed. Then taking the Maybelline Mousse Finish Consistency liquid lipstick, I am just going ahead and applying it onto the lips. The shade that I am using is Plum Feather, and this is not at all a plum shade, but it turns out a little bit different on the camera. It's just a subtle muted pink in person, and the camera catches it up as if it's an orange tingy type of a pink. But now switching over to eyes, I have applied a tape onto my eyes because I'm willing to go ahead with a very sharp edge. And now I have taken the Nykaa's gel eyeliner, applied it onto the outer V, and then blending it with the help of my brush. Now taking the Dreamcatcher eyeshadow palette from the NYX, I am just blending the black shade onto the areas where I did apply that kajal pencil and smudged it, just making sure that it's looking seamless. Then taking a matching shade from the Balm Meet Matte palette, and I am taking a cleaner blending brush and I'm just blending that shade onto my crease above the black shade that is there. It will just guide you as an edge and just keep the black shade beneath the matching shade. Now I'm taking my Makeup Revolution's highlighting palette, and I'm just taking the yellow toned first stripe of my highlighter, and I'm using it as an eyeshadow at the moment, and this turned out superbly well. Like, this highlighter was amazing as an eyeshadow as well. Now taking the Nykaa's I'm Black eyeliner, I'm just lining my eyes, making sure there is a small wing, and I'm lining them very thinly, just going ahead with all of those ooms and ahs. When you go ahead and do your eye makeup, and intricate eye makeup requires a complete winged eyeliner. So that's what I'm trying to achieve, and I'm slowly building up my wing. Now taking the Chambers mascara, this is one of the best mascaras that I ever have. If you people haven't watched my 5 favorite mascaras video, then you should go ahead and watch it. I'll link it in the description box for you all, so don't forget to check that out as well. And I'm coating my lashes with this mascara, and this is an amazing mascara. I'm just gonna apply it onto my upper as well as lower lashes, but lower lashes will be covered later after I apply my kajal pencil. Never ever apply your kajal after you apply your mascara onto the bottom lashes, because trust me, it will cost you really heavily. It will smudge all your bottom makeup, and it will break down your mascara, and it will fall onto the lower lashes. So now you can see me covering up my lower lashes as well with the help of the same mascara. And here I'm adding on some accessories, just going ahead with my bangles at the moment, applying some Mantika. Just I feel that it just finishes off the look pretty well. Wearing up my earrings, just making sure that all of those essential steps are completed, that will make sure that I am looking presentable for the festival. And applying some bindi, and here is the finished look, you guys. And I hope you all have enjoyed it, and if you did, then please give this video a massive thumbs up. Let's see whether this video can reach up to 50 likes or not. And with that being said, I'll take care all of you, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Till then, stay blessed. Don't forget to follow. Don't forget to participate in the giveaway. And please subscribe to my channel. I'll see you all in the next video. Bye. I can fly.